Hello and welcome. This is Shani Nebnani and you are watching It's Tomorrow News. Typhoon Tapah lashes South Korea after lashing Japan, several injured. A powerful typhoon battered southern South Korea, injuring 26 people and knocking out power to about 27,790 houses, officials said on September 23rd. Typhoon Tapah earlier lashed parts of Japan's southern islands with heavy rains and winds that caused flooding and some minor injuries. South Korea's Interior Ministry said the typhoon also caused strong winds and heavy rainfall in southern South Korean cities and towns on Sunday and Monday. The storm did not make landfall on the peninsula as it moved northeast and weakened on Monday. The ministry said one person was hurt seriously and the 25 others had minor injuries. It flooded streets, damaged houses and led to about 250 flight cancellations in 11 airports in South Korea, according to the ministry report. Typhoon Tapah hit the southern Japanese island of Okinawa on September 20 and 21st and left 18 people with minor injuries. The storm disrupted air and train travel in the region during what is a three-day holiday weekend. Typhoon Tapah left dozens of people injured in southern and southwestern Japan, weakened to an extratropical cyclone on Monday in the Sea of Japan, the Japan Meteorological Agency said. The season's 17th typhoon, which traveled over the sea through Monday morning, has left more than 50 people injured in the Okinawa and Kyushu regions as it brought strong winds over the weekend, according to the Fire and Disaster Management Agency. Kyushu Electric Power Company said blackouts affected prefectures on the island of Kyushu, with over 30,000 homes without power at one point. Some air and rail traffic disruption also continued in the region, Kyushu Railway Company and Airlines said. The weather agency said warm, humid air is moving in over western and eastern Japan and may bring heavy rain to some areas. Meteorological agency warned of strong winds, high waves and landslides triggered by heavy rains through Monday in western parts of the country. That's all for now. For more news updates, stay tuned with us. It's Tomorrow News, Chandni Nebnani. For more weather updates, do like, subscribe our channel.